Now, The Golden Voyage of Sinbad is my favorite of the three Sinbad movies made by the great special effects master Ray Harryhausen, and it's one of my favorite Ray Harryhausen movies altogether. It, as a kid, it was the first one I got to see in an actual movie theater on a widescreen, so I'm very nostalgic towards it because of that. It's got a really strong story. It's got a great cast, especially Tom Baker as the bad guy. This was the role that impressed the makers of the TV show Doctor Who enough to cast Tom Baker as Doctor Who, and he was the best actor ever in that role also. And here, he's just a great villain. Now, as good as this movie is, there is an awkwardly edited scene towards the end that inexplicably causes a character to vanish from the film. And we're going to take a look at that here. In just a moment, we're going to meet a sailor named Omar. Now, he's very much a secondary character in this film. He's not a key character. But in the beginning of the movie here, that's him, that's Omar right there. He's going to, on his own initiative, try and peg that flying creature with an arrow. And that is going to be the first of a sequence of events that forces Sinbad to go on a very dangerous quest. So we get Omar's name, and we get a sense of his personality, that he tends to be a little bit impetuous. So later on in the movie, Sinbad's going to take a landing party ashore on an island. He's going to take the other major named characters with him. He's going to have Omar, and he's going to have a couple of sailors whose names we never even get to learn. And these two sailors are the red shirts of the landing party. They're going to end up, they're there just so they can end up getting killed in a fight scene a little later on. But Omar is going to survive until the final confrontation with a monster they have to fight near the end of the film. And here's the beginning of that fight. The surviving members of Sinbad's landing party are about to confront a monster. And we can see Omar. There he is, right there, clear as day, standing just to the right of Sinbad. So he's definitely there. Then, as the scene continues, we get a close-up of the monster. It's one of Harryhausen's coolest monsters. It's a mishmash of a cyclops and a centaur. And here we get a point of view shot as he approaches the humans. Omar's still there, isn't he? He's obviously about to take part in the fight. We get a close-up of the monster again, and then he starts to charge, and by golly, where the heck did Omar go? He should be standing just in front of the guy in the back. His name is Harun. And as the scene continues, we see Harun cut to our right. So what happened to Omar? Well, most of this fight scene is a great fight scene. Which is very well choreographed, and it flows along in a logical manner. We can follow the action, and Ray Harryhausen, of course, does his usual brilliant job of animating the monster to be a menace and to even give it a little bit of personality, something that he was truly great at. But at the beginning of this fight scene, there's definitely this awkward bit of editing where Omar simply seems to disappear. But I like continuity in my movies, by golly, so I'm going to come up with a theory to explain what happened to Omar. So I'm going to presume that just before the centaur charged, Omar, on his own initiative, decided to circle around to what would be our right, just like Harun is doing now, to try and get to the side or to the rear of the centaur so the humans could attack it from multiple directions. A perfectly reasonable tactic to take. And he had started this move already, so he was already off screen. But what happens next? The centaur charges. We get a brief close-up of Sinbad standing against that rock that's now to our left, but then there's a cut in which we obviously lose a few seconds because Sinbad's now behind the rock rather than standing in front of it. And also, Harun, who was moving to our right, is now back over on the left side with him. And by golly, it's our last view of Omar, who's apparently dead. We can see his feet there sticking out from behind the rock. So what happened in those few seconds that we were getting a close-up of Sinbad and that we apparently lost a few seconds due to a bad edit? Well, here's my theory. We know that Omar, or we're presuming rather, that Omar was circling around to the right and Harun was following him, both with the idea of flanking the centaur. The centaur, though, charged and then also moved to the right and cutting them off. He grabbed Omar. And Harun had no choice but to retreat back over to where Sinbad and the first mate were. And in the meantime, the centaur broke Omar's neck or killed him in some other horrible way and tossed his body over to the left as well. And that's what happened in those few missing seconds. And that's why Omar is lying dead there. And that's why Harun, who had been moving to the right, is now over back over on the left side. That's just my explanation for what otherwise would be a continuity gaffe in the film. Now, as I said, from them on, we get a really great fight scene. And we could follow the action without any problem at all from then on. But we do have that little bit of awkwardness there. Since I like my movies to have a great continuity, that's my explanation for how Omar met his doom.